I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails, and in this video we're going to do some New Year's Eve nails! So in this design I'm going to hand paint a London skyline with fireworks going off. Is that the kind of noise they make?
Bang.
Yeah, it's more like... You like that, don't you, as well? Yeah. We'll do some sound effects on that. Help me. I'm going to do this design over the 5 nails, so you're going to get a full look. It's all going to be hand painted, but first of all, we need to sculpt out a gorgeous ballerina shape. So I'm going to do this with a sculpting form. So I've got the tab on the back. I'm going to wrap that between my thumbs to give it a nice curve. And closing the end, you're going to imagine you're doing a stiletto. So that's how we start off this ballerina shape. If you want to see a video that just shows you how to create a ballerina shape, check out this link here over my shoulder, on there. So it's nice and tight. Because we want a nice C curve. I'm going to prep the nail now with dehydrator. I've already removed the surface shine from this nail because we've actually soaked off some nails. So it's already abrased. And then we are going to put on primer. And I'm going to do 2 coats of that. Letting the first coat dry. I'm going to use natural beige to sculpt this out. My favourite colour. I know I use it a lot. I do apologise, but I love it. In my dampen dish, I have high speed because I'm going to sculpt it all out in one go. So you pick up a nice big bead, tipping the finger down. I'm just laying that down. Nice and long. I'm going to sort out the back, make sure it's nice and flush from side to side. And make sure you've got that apex in there. If you don't know what an apex is, you need to check out the video that's titled, what's it titled, Adam? Nail Technician Terminology or something like that.
So you don't even need me. You know everything yourself.
Yeah, we do need you. I need you in my life.
only for short periods of time.
Just while we're filming. So the advantage of sculpting it all out in one bead means that it's all going to set at the same time, which makes it easier to pinch the nail. You'll get a nicer shape. You've got to work quick. Obviously, I'm using high speed. You don't have to use high speed. You could use max adhesion. Or you could use the medium set. It depends how quick you want it to set. I'm gonna let that set up a little bit. I'm gonna pop the pinching tool on now. So this is gonna slim the nail down. It's gonna pinch in a nice C curve. I'm gonna pinch the tip of the nail now. I can take this form off. And I can pinch the tip even more because I can loop down the barrel of the nail. I'm going to file it into shape now, doing my usual filing routine, side walls first. So as you're filing the side walls, you're actually filing the free edge shape at the same time. So round the cuticle, just to make that nice and flush. You don't want a lip at the back. If you have thickness at the back here, it's going to lift. And we don't want it to lift because then the client's going to come back and go, oh, my nails have been lifting. And if there's a point that they can see that lifting, do you know what they'll do? I will just do it. Oh, look, it's just fell off. They'll pick it off. So we don't want no lifting. And then over the top, we're going to contour the top surface of the nail. So you can see that I twist the finger like this so I can get in a little bit easier. I'm going to go over with the white sanding block just to remove the demarcations, make sure it's nice and smooth. So I've wiped over with acetone just to clean those up, and it's also going to melt the top surface slightly. It makes it nice and smooth. As smooth as, not my face. And now we're going to paint. I've got my palette. I'm going to pop some colours on there because we're going to do the background first. Oh my God, I'm not strong enough. So we've got, what's that one called? Ultramarine. And then we've got primary blue, and we've got white, and then we've got, what have we got here? Violet. So I just want to say purple, but I'm telling you the correct colours. And then we've got primary red, and this is primary yellow. So with my brush, I'm going to use this dark purple right at the top. And we're going to do the same background on the four nails. You're going to leave the thumb. And rinse my brush. And I'm just going to blend that a little bit. And then we're going to go in with the marine, the ultramarine colour. And overlap that. I'm drying off the brush so it's got not much paint on, and I'm just going to dab that down so we can then overlap that again. Rinse my brush, and we're going to use the primary red and overlap. I'm going to get a little bit more of that blue to help this blend. And then a bit more of the magenta. Then we've got some of the yellow. And just blend on that. Now I'm showing you this nail, you know, at one time, but you don't have to do one nail at a time. You could do all the blue, all the purple, all the pink, all the yellow. You could do it like that across the four nails. You don't need to go down to the tip. That's gonna have something else on it. So you're just creating that fade at first. I'm gonna put a little bit more purple at the back just to make that a little bit stronger. Then we're gonna create that look on all of these four nails. So that's all complete and it's dry. Now I'm going to turn the hand over, because this is how we're going to do it. We're going to do it as if it's a picture going across the nails. So I want all four nails together to see where I'm going to line everything up. So the tips need to be black. So we've got some black paint. And I'm literally just going to paint across the tip. I think I'm going to use a bigger brush, because this would be easier. To literally just paint black, because this is going to be a skyline. So they're all going to start from the bottom there. So we're going to do the silhouettes of London 10. So we have, if you think about the iconic sort of buildings that you see in London, you've got
the Houses of Parliament.
House of Parliament, Tower Bridge. They call it the Gherkin, don't they?
Mm.
What is that?
It's a skyscraper.
Yeah, we got that. Big Ben. And
it's the House of Parliament.
Yeah, on. Oh, is it separate? Is it on it?
No, it's part of it.
Part of it, yeah.
Big Ben's the bell.
Yeah. Ah, Big Ben is just the bell, isn't
it? Yeah.
And then we've got the London Eye, which is a wheel thing. So we're going to do the side of the towers, because there's little sort of tower things. And do it on either side. And we're going to do it as if the bridge is opening. Tower Bridge has like these little pointy things on the top of the columns. Going to do little flags at the top of here, and then we're going to move on and do part of the Houses of Parliament. I couldn't think what they were called that. And we're going to do the Gherkin. They call it the Gherkin. I don't even know what's in that building. I am going to mix a little bit of white into some of the black just to make it a bit grey. Then we're going to do a little bit of the Houses of Parliament here. Before you all start and say, well, it's not that close. Houses of Parliament isn't that close to the Gherkin. We're just, you know, doing the popular buildings. Fill this black and then we can add any highlights for the windows after. I'm just doing some of the detail at the top of the Houses of Parliament. So we've painted the little windows in. The next nail needs to line up with this. So I'm gonna put those together. Get the black paint. We're gonna do Big Ben. That's the tower that it sits on, and then it comes out wider and then goes back in, and we have like a pointy top. And then mixing a grey colour again, I'm going to add a little bit of detail. I'm going to do the clock at midnight, and then with the white, just going to highlight where the numbers would be ever so slightly. And we're going to do the little windows. On this one, we're going to do the wheel, which is the London Eye. Now, this is the hard bit. You've got to do this circle. And we're just putting the detail in now. So with the white, I'm just going to put a bit of highlight onto the little pods. I'm going to seal that with Mega Gloss. Make sure you cap all of this work. Now, I know what you're thinking. It doesn't look very New Year's Eve at the minute. It just looks like a London skyline, and you'd be right, but we're going to add fireworks to make it New Year's Eve. While that's in the lamp, I'm going to take some mega gloss. Some mega gloss onto the backing of a sculpting form. And we're going to mix some of the holographic chrome powder in with that. And we're going to use this for our fireworks. So I've got a fine detail brush. And just get creative and add random fireworks shapes. They're just little strokes of glitter. So I'm just flash curing that so it stays still. I'm going to do this across the rest of the nails. So they're all cured. I can finish those off with cuticle oil now, and then we'll go on to doing the thumb. You can see that the design follows across all the nails, and it still looks cool going across like this as well. Why is it called the London Eye? Because it sees all over London.
Hang on, I'll Google it after I've Googled this one.
Oh, that's all right.
So the Palace of Westminster was built in 1016. Eh? Right, and then it was demolished in 1834 due to fire, and then it was rebuilt in 1740 to 70, so it took 30 years to rebuild it.
Wow. Oh.
Are you listening, kids? This is a history lesson. From us old English people.
Yeah, us old English people from London. Even though we're not from London. But we love London. London town.